Hello and welcome to this special broadcast on Rajya Sabha Television. The day, of course, is dedicated to M. Venkaiah Naidu. From a farmer's son to becoming the next Vice President of India, let's take a look at his political journey.
Was 1949, barely 2 years after India won her independence. Political activity was at its peak, and the state of Andhra Pradesh was still years away from its formation. On July 1st, Muppavarappu Venkaiah Naidu was born in Chavattapalam village of Nellore district that was under the Madras Presidency. Venkaiah Naidu's father, Rangaiah Naidu, was a farmer. Theirs was a family of limited means. While he was still a child, Venkaiah Naidu's father took him to Nellore, where he enrolled at the VR High School. Besides being good at studies, Venkaiah showed an acute awareness about political developments. He was still in his primary school when the struggle began for a state of Andhra Pradesh. Poti Sriramulu had started an indefinite hunger strike, and his death on December 15, 1952 sparked violent protests. It led to the formation of Andhra Pradesh, India's first state that was carved on linguistic lines. Poti Sriramulu belonged to Nellore, one reason why his struggle made a deep impact on the young lad. As he grew older, studies and politics went hand in hand. Venkaiah enrolled for a bachelor's degree in politics and diplomatic studies. He took his early steps in student politics at VR College and in a short time became one of the most promising leaders of the Akhil Bharatiya Vidyarthi Parishad, the student wing of the Rashtriya Swayamsevak Sangh. In 1971, Venkaiah Naidu was elected president in the college elections.
I come from a humble agricultural background. I don't have great family history and all. We were people committed to agriculture, which is our basic culture. And from that humble background, I have risen to this level because of the support given to me by the people, by the Bharatiya Janata Party.
After graduating in political science, Venkaiah Naidu acquired a bachelor's degree in law from the Andhra University College of Law in Visakhapatnam. Keen to understand the finer points of international law, he specialized in the subject. But politics remained his first love. From 1973 to 1974, Venkaiah was the president of the Andhra University Students' Union. In 1974, he became the state convener of the Lok Nayak Jay Prakash Narayan Students' Sangharshana Committee. The political involvement brought him a fair share of fame. In 1972, Andhra Pradesh was gripped by an intense agitation against the Mulki rules. Mulki rules were framed after a massive agitation in 1952. They were meant to give preference to the natives of Hyderabad in jobs. But as the years passed, people from the coastal states and the Rayalaseema region found them discriminatory. They complained that all the development was taking place in regions in and around Hyderabad, while the coastal region and Rayalaseema were being neglected. They started the Jai Andhra agitation in retaliation. In 1972, Venkaiah Naidu joined this struggle. More than 400 people lost their lives in the Jai Andhra agitation. It marked a huge shift in the state's politics. 9 legislators resigned from the state assembly and Chief Minister P.V. Narasimha Rao was forced to quit. The agitation propelled Venkaiya Naidu into the forefront of the state's politics. Never one to rest on his laurels, Venkaiya Naidu soon immersed himself in the JPF movement that was gathering force across the country. He soon joined the fight against corruption in the country. As the agitation spread, Venkaiya Naidu was arrested and remained in jail between 1975 and 1977. But no sooner was he released that once again he found himself in the thick of the movement.
మేమ చిన్నవాడు బాగా తెలియదు బాగా చదువుకొని పైలు లేకొచ్చి లాయర్ చదివి అమ్మాయినిచ్చి వివాహం అయిన తర్వాత ఆయన విశాఖపట్నం చదివారు చదివినాక మళ్ళా ఎమర్జెంట్లో అదేందో నాకు అన్నీ కూడా గుర్తు ఇందిరాగాంధీ ఎమర్జెంట్లో ఉన్నారు ఇద్దరు బిడ్డ పా అమ్మాయి బాబు పుట్టారు మా అక్క మా బావే పెంచారు ఊళ్ళో అమ్మగారి ఇంటికాడ ఉండించుకొని తర్వాత మిలిటరీ కాలు ఇళ్ళు కట్టి ఉదయగిరిలో ఎమ్మెల్యేగా గెలిచారు ఆయన అక్కడనే హైదరాబాద్కి వెళ్ళారు మంచిగా నంచులంచులుగా బాగా జరిగి బాగా మంచిగా బాగా వచ్చారు మాకు ఇప్పుడు అంతా బాగా ఆనందంగా సంబరంగా ఉంది.
పాలిటిక్స్ వాజ్ ఎ వే ఆఫ్ లైఫ్ ఫర్ వెంకయ్య నాయుడు. In 1977, the Janata Party entrusted him the responsibility of leading its youth wing as its president. He continued in the post till 1980, strengthening and invigorating the organization. Venkaiya Naidu's oratory had already won him a huge fan following from his student days, but it was in active politics that he came to be recognized as a brilliant communicator. In 1980, when the BJP was formed, Venkaiya Naidu was made the vice president of its youth wing. He held the post for 3 years, during which his stature grew within the party. In 1978, he contested and won the Udayagiri assembly seat, a seat he won again in 1983. It was only a matter of time before Venkaiya Naidu was recognized as the tallest leader of the BJP in Andhra Pradesh. From 1980 to 1985, he was the leader of the BJP in the state assembly, after which he became the general secretary of the Andhra Pradesh BJP. Witness to his phenomenal organizational abilities, the BJP gave him a bigger role in party affairs and in 1988 made him the president of the Andhra Pradesh BJP.
Venkaiya ji bahut jameen se jude hue karyakarta rehte ab rashtriya neta bane hain aur iske liye jo aam karyakarta ki peeda hai usko bahut dil se samajhne wale uske bare mein sochne wale और आम कार्यकर्ता को आवश्यकता के अनुसार जो भी राहत देना जरूरी होता है वो देने वाले ऐसे एक हमारे अभिभावक के रूप में हम वेंकैया जी की तरफ देखते रहे हैं. मगर मैं उनकी कार्यशैली की अगर विशेषता बतानी है तो बहुत कम नेता ऐसे होते हैं जो अगर 5 बजे का समय तय हुआ है तो 5 बजे के पहले 1 मिनट उपस्थित रहते हैं.
Under his leadership, the party's roots were strengthened immensely in the state, which paved the way for Venkaiya Naidu's debut in national politics. He became the BJP's National General Secretary in 1993 and remained in this post till the year 2000. In this period, Venkaiya Naidu was entrusted with many other party responsibilities. From 1996 till the year 2000, he was not only the party's spokesperson, but also secretary of the BJP Parliamentary Board and its Central Election Committee. In April 1998, Venkaiya Naidu entered the Rajya Sabha for the first time from Karnataka. He became a member of many Rajya Sabha committees, playing a key role in the parliamentary committees of the Ministry of Home Affairs, Ministry of Agriculture, Ministry of Finance, and the Ministry of External Affairs. He was also a member of the Tobacco Board. The committees submitted several important reports to Parliament with significant contributions by Venkaiya Naidu.
जिस पद्धति से उन्होंने पार्टी की बुनियादी सोच को बहुत आसान तरीके से लोगों तक पहुंचाया, वो मंत्री थे, मंत्री बनने के बाद कार्यकर्ता के रूप में जब उनको कहा गया तो उन्होंने दायित्व तो संभाल लिया, पार्टी के अध्यक्ष बने। कोई आसान नहीं था ये, मगर उन्होंने निर्णय किया और फिर अध्यक्ष बने। तो कुछ समय के बाद फिर अध्यक्ष पद और किसी को मिला। बावजूद इसके इतने सारे उतार चढ़ाव, वो एक अहम नेता के रूप में हमेशा काम करते रहे। राज्यसभा में बहुत अच्छी छाप उन्होंने सदन के कामकाज पर छोड़ी।
In 1998, the National Democratic Alliance, the NDA, was formed. Atal Bihari Vajpayee became the Prime Minister and the BJP increased its spread rapidly. In September 2000, Venkaiah Naidu became a cabinet minister in the Vajpayee government. He was Rural Development Minister for 2 years and started initiatives like the Pradhan Mantri Gram Sadak Yojana, besides many other ambitious projects.
As a party functionary, at the state level, at the national level, and also as a central minister, both in the rural development, urban development, parliamentary affairs, information and broadcasting and housing, I had the opportunity of going around the nook and corner of the country. Extensive tour has been mine. Way of life, interacting with the people, meeting the people, greeting the people, talking to the people, walking with the people, working with the people. That has been my passion.
The real representative of the South, Andhra, Karnataka, Karnataka se chunkar aaye the Rajya Sabha ko, lekin Rashtriya Adhyaksh aate, uske pehle General Secretary aate, Karnataka, Andhra, Tamil Nadu, Kerala, ye charon ke bare mein achhi tarah jante hain. So he is the real representative of the South India. But I don't want to confine himself to a south area, because after becoming the national president, वो इतना अधिक tour किए हैं। वो मंत्री बनने के बाद मैंने, I don't know about the other ministers, कम से कम मैं कहना दोबारे के में मैं ये बता सकता हूँ, वो rural minister बनने के बाद पूरा भारत देश उनको घूम कर आया है, गांव गांव जाकर क्या क्या है।
Then came an important chapter in Venkaiah Naidu's political career, his election as the BJP national president. It was a position that he used wholeheartedly to strengthen the party. He was re-elected to the post, but then came the electoral debacle for the NDA in 2004, and Venkaiah Naidu resigned from the post.
मैं पहले से उनको जानता था, पर 2002 से उनके संपर्क में ज्यादा आया और उनको और बारीकी से समझने का अवसर मिला। वो 96 से सांसद के रूप में थे, मैं भी सांसद के रूप में था। अटल जी की सरकार में वो ग्रामीण विकास मंत्री थे। मैं अनेक समस्याएं लेकर के जाता रहा हूं, उन्होंने उन समस्याओं का समाधान किया और मुझे ऐसा लगता है कि उन्होंने जब उनसे मिला मैं और मेरी सोच, मेरी कार्यशैली और इसको देखा, तो बाद में उनको राष्ट्रीय अध्यक्ष बनाया गया 2002 में और उन्होंने मुझे राष्ट्रीय सचिव बनाया था।
In 2004, Venkaiah Naidu was elected to the Rajya Sabha for the second time. By now, he had joined the small but elite club of senior leaders who had shaped the party's history. In the Rajya Sabha, he became the chairman of the Parliamentary Committee of the Home Ministry and the Petitions Committee. He was also a member of the committees of Ministry of Finance, Ministry of Agriculture and the Ministry of Consumer Affairs. In 2010, Venkaiah Naidu won the membership of the Rajya Sabha from Karnataka for the third time. His contribution as member of the Parliamentary Forum on Disaster Management was immense. But issues relating to farming and poverty always found in him an enthusiastic champion who started many progressive initiatives. 2014 saw a historic general election that swept the NDA led by Narendra Modi to power in the Lok Sabha. The new government came with a tremendous responsibility, and it was to Venkaiah Naidu that Prime Minister Modi turned, entrusting him the ministries of Parliamentary Affairs and Housing and Urban Poverty Alleviation. Later, he was made the Information and Broadcasting Minister as well. On May 29, 2016, Venkaiah Naidu was elected to the Rajya Sabha for the fourth time. As a seasoned parliamentarian and parliamentary affairs minister, Venkaiah Naidu is well versed in the rules and regulations of parliamentary practices. No wonder then, the NDA found him best suited for the office of the Vice President. The high-level BJP meeting that nominated him as the NDA candidate was unanimous about his choice.
पार्लियामेंट्री बोर्ड के सभी सदस्य और एनडीए के सभी साथियों से चर्चा करने के बाद पार्लियामेंट्री बोर्ड इन निर्णय पर पहुंचा है कि भाजपा के वरिष्ठ नेता और अर्बन डेवलपमेंट मिनिस्टर श्री एम वेंकैया नायडू जी एनडीए की ओर से उपराष्ट्रपति पद के लिए प्रत्याशी होंगे।
आई डीम इट एज ऑनर to be nominated as a candidate for the august position of the Vice President of India's Republic. You are all aware I have been actively engaged in public life for over 4 decades.
Rajya Sabha ke sabhapati bhi aur Rajya Sabha ke hi sadasya होते होते वो एलिवेट हो करके अब वहाँ के सभापति बनेंगे, ये भी अपने में एक विशेष बात है। जो जो भी लोग कार्यकर्ता हों या संगठन से बाहर भी हों, वेंकैया जी को जो नज़दीक से जानते हैं, जिन्होंने देखा है, वो सदा ये बात कहेंगे कि वेंकैया जी के व्यक्तित्व में हमेशा पॉजिटिविटी रही। अपने जूनियर्स का प्रोत्साहन करना, मार्गदर्शन करना और उनकी कार्यशैली में अत्यंत फोकस्ड अप्रोच, ऊर्जा से भरपूर।
While Venkaiah Naidu has piloted key measures for the welfare of the poor while remaining in the government, his contributions outside it are no less praiseworthy. In 2001, with the help of a few friends, he set up the Swarna Bharat Trust.
The idea in establishing the school was to help the children who are being dropped from the school and wandering in the streets, and our trust is collecting them and bringing them here and make them ready, and their education, which was irregular, found was made regular, and they were again rejoined in the regular government schools. That is our idea.
The trust is at present managed by Venkaiah Naidu's daughter, but he does chart out its programs and takes part in the major activities of the trust. One of them is the education of child dropouts, besides taking care of their needs.
He is a great person and he has great vision. He is very much fond of children, sir. So he always wants to train up the children and the backdrop, especially the dropouts in villages. He wants to village poor especially. So he always concentrates on the village poor, rural poor.
The trust makes special arrangements to skill young people and house the elderly. Many people stay at the old age home run by it, while people come from afar for treatment at its hospital. Venkaiah Naidu has also helped set up self-help groups for hundreds of women. He always confesses a special attachment to the poor. His close friends and well-wishers say whenever he is in Nellore, he makes it a point to ask about everyone, not failing to call on old acquaintances and friends who are thrilled to recount stories and experiences with him.
Police or attack is done. Nadu, Nidhuura Nadu. Now, Palithuran job ko khunda, Thouran job ko na. Say that better Nadu. Antle ke, ne matalak pina police to. Ii na palimanje students to vastam Nadu. టిఫిన్కి వస్తున్నాడు బజార్కి, ఆ సైజు చూసే ఎంబ్రాక్ కొండావు అన్నాడు. ఇంకా సైకిల్ పట్టుకున్నారు, రాంగ్ రూట్లో వచ్చానని అంటే వాడు పల్లెటూరు వాడే, వాడు ఉంది పట్టుకుంది వాడు అన్నాడు. ఈ సందు ఒక 50 మంది స్టూడెంట్స్ అంతా పోగి అయిపోయినారు. ఈ లోపల ఒకడు సైకిల్ ఆడు పెట్టి టిఫిన్కి పోయినాడు. ఈయన నన్ను కొని కొట్టేశాడు సైకిల్ ఎత్తుకొని పోరా అని. ఈ జనాలు ఈ సైకిల్ ఎత్తుకుపోయి ఆఫీసులో పెట్టేసిన, ఆఫీసులో పెట్టేస్తే వాడు వచ్చి పోలీసు వాడు ఇంకొకరు సైకిల్ ఎత్తుకొని రిక్షాలో పెట్టుకొని పోబోతున్నాడు.
Endowed with simplicity and an affable nature, Venkaiah Naidu's popularity cuts across parties. No wonder opposition leaders find him a credible leader and even a trusted friend. Venkaiah Naidu, who once opposed Hindi, is one of the very few South Indian leaders who are not only popular in the so-called Hindi belt but also well-versed in the language. A good speaker, an experienced politician and an MP with a good understanding of the parliamentary process. Having been a member of the Rajya Sabha four times, Venkaiah Naidu has been closely associated with the working of the House. A multifaceted personality as the 13th Vice President, Venkaiah Naidu is expected to make a distinct mark as the chairman of the Rajya Sabha.